What is 75 hard?
It's a mental toughness plan or mental toughness challenge that forces you to do your activities or your daily task every single day, no matter how you're feeling, no matter how the weather is, no matter the emotions attached to the task. You mandatory, you just have to do it, okay? It's not easy, which is why it's called 75 hard. Obviously there is a lot of physical change that happens, but that's only a small fraction of the actual change that happens inside to your mental mind state, okay?
What are the things that you have to do when you do 75 hard?
To do is finish a gallon, which is actually two of these. I drink a gallon every single day. I do two 45 minute workouts minimum. One mandatory, just has to be outside no matter what, whether it's cold, whether it's raining or snowing. Two of these, 10 pages from a self-development book, like social media, you maybe want to read like Crush It by Gary Vee, which is actually what I'm currently reading. It's just something to push you forward in life, okay? You don't want to just read like a novel just for the fun of it. It should have some added value other than just reading. What else I have to do is a progress picture every single day. So that one's really annoying. It's tedious because sometimes you're in bed, you're like, yeah, I did everything. Then you're like, damn, didn't take a picture. You gotta get up, get your picture in real quick. Again, that's that mental aspect. A lot of people might think that's dumb. It's like unnecessary, but it instills that fact of like, when you don't want to do something that you said you were gonna do, you're still gonna go ahead and do it. You know what I'm saying? So doing that for 75 days in a row, it gets instilled into you. No cheat meals. So whatever meal plan that you say you're gonna stick to, you have to stick to, okay? If you say no fried food, no fried food. Also, no alcohol, okay? No cheat meals.
Why are you doing 75 hard?
I want to instill those characteristics into me. I do feel like they're vital, especially when there's certain tasks that I say I was gonna get done, and maybe work was too much, or maybe I'm just feeling too tired and I don't want to do it. I push it to the next day. It doesn't help me, as well as I typically have a hard time sleeping at night. I'm always asking myself, did I do enough? Was I productive enough? For some reason, all of that comes up at night. Like, it just hits you, like you forgot to freaking tie your shoe when you got up in the morning. I don't know. I just want to be a better person. You know, I just want to be stronger mentally and physically.
What is the most difficult part of completing your daily tasks?
The most difficult part of, I would say it was certainly the gallon, because for the first 15 days, I was actually fasting. Not religious. I was mostly doing it for my grandmother. But it completely changed up everything. It changed up my sleeping schedule, when I could work out, when I could eat and drink. So of those of you who know how fasting works, from sunrise to sundown, you're not allowed to eat or drink water, any liquids at all. I wake up around 2-3 p.m. Typically I get my reading done. Maybe I'll do a walk outside, a 45 minute walk outside. Once 8 o'clock hits, I break my fast, I eat some food, and then from 8 p.m. to about 4:30 a.m., I have that time period to finish an entire gallon of water. So for me, that was by far the most difficult part.
Why 70 hard? Why 75 hard versus diet or regular plan?
The reason why I wanted to choose 75 hard is because for me, I've never really had the problem of eating correctly, or I've never had the problem of working out, you know what I'm saying, maintaining myself. But I want to take it a step further. I want my body to perform at its very best, and I want to feel my very best, because when you have that mental fog or anything, you're not mentally clear, you don't have that clarity, it gets much harder to do regular tasks, yet alone freaking work out or drink a gallon of water. So I feel like giving myself tasks to do throughout the day on top of everything else I have to do, it's keeping me going, it's keeping me sane. I'm happy, I feel productive. And during this whole quarantine thing, it's just like the days are all like combined together, okay? So this really helps me, like, hey, today's today. This is, you know what I'm saying, boom, boom, boom. So it's a mental toughness challenge, okay? So that's why I'm choosing this versus anything else.
How did you feel after completing 75 hard for the first time?
Oh man, I felt amazing. Honestly, I felt really, really great. I was super proud of myself, you know, something I didn't think was possible. I lost 20 pounds, so everyone Like, I was like really ripped. So everyone assumed that this was a diet, a workout routine plan that I was following, but it's not. Again, it's a small fraction of what really changes and happens to you, okay? But I felt amazing, and I still regret it to this day that I did not keep up with it. You know, my groin was very, very tight for that first challenge, so I was done with working out. I was like, I need a week off at least, just so my body can recuperate. I had to get massages, stretch out a lot, because it's so much tension when you're working out twice a day, every single day with no rest day. Your body starts to like break down. So I was definitely sore, but I felt amazing.
Why did you choose to fast while doing 75 hard?
Fasting would make it interesting. I've already completed 75 hard, so I'm just like, why not add a little something in there?
Like a twist.
A little twist, as well as I want to make my grandmother proud. And I kind of just want to see if I could do it, you know? I love challenges, so.
How were you able to do these last couple of days doing this 75 hard with quarantine?
Obviously, the gyms being closed has changed up the ball game for everybody, okay? You have to get innovative, you have to have fun, maybe you have to change up your environment, okay? Like, my brother actually changed up my room atmosphere, so I have more room to, like, work out. It certainly helped a lot. Your workouts, just, it's inevitable, you have to change it, but you have to find the fun in it, you have to look forward to it. You know, everyone's dreading these at-home workouts. I mean, they're not my favorite either. I, 10 times out of 10, rather go to the gym than work out at home, but it is what it is, okay? It's the situation that we're in, you know what I'm saying? You just have to make it work with what the cards you're given. That's the biggest thing for me, is just keep going. Whether it's something small, I'd rather something than nothing, okay? Because you're either getting better or worse. There's no I'm staying the same, okay? So that's what you have to remember.
And it's for everyone that's watching this,
yeah,
is stay safe, stay strong, and stay home.
Stay strong, stay safe, and stay home. My diet, chose to do no red meat, not eating pork, no deep fried foods, no ice cream. Trying to stay away from like high sugary things. I'm not gonna say stay away from sugar, because that's damn near impossible, but just watch what I'm eating. I've certainly lost weight, which is not the goal, because of the fasting, but still at it, you know what I'm saying? Still at it. Thank you for watching. Till next time.